guys, it's Paige Poppy. Welcome back for another video. Today is going to be an art supply haul. I actually think I'm gonna film two of these videos so you guys will get another one in the future because I took two trips to art stores and you know, I go really often and I usually pick up like one or two things, but I went on a couple like big trips where I picked up like multiple items and I went to two different stores. So this haul is going to be from Arizona Art Supply. I live in Scottsdale, Arizona. So Arizona Art Supply is an awesome store that I love to go to. Very high quality, like very helpful people. I just love it there. And they have a bunch of locations. I actually went to a new location that I haven't been to before in Mesa. So I will be sharing with you what I got there. And as a side note, I hope this hat isn't like annoying. I know the shadow is kind of bad. I've really been into wearing this hat lately, and now that I've been wearing it for like most of the day, I can't take it off because I'll have like hat hair. So hopefully we can deal with it. I should say also, if you guys don't know, I am an artist. I work in watercolor and acrylic, and that's kind of what you'll see as like a pattern in the supplies I bought today too, but let's jump right in. Okay, so one thing that I always pick up when I run out of are watercolor postcards. I have previously used the Arches or Arches block of postcard paper, and I've also used the Strathmore paper pad. But this time I ended up getting the Winsor & Newton Cotman watercolor paper, which is awesome because I use the Winsor & Newton Cotman watercolor tubes for my paintings. So you know, the paint and the paper, like same product, same brand, they probably go together well. So I'm excited to try this. I haven't tried a Winsor & Newton paper before, so that'll be really fun. It's 140-pound cold pressed paper, and they're 4x6, which is great because you could also pop them really easily into a 4x6 frame. Kind of like this one, for example. I have one of my quote paintings in this frame. So yeah, that's like the same size, fits right in there. I feel like I'm being so casual in this video today. But I really like these because they have the postcard lines for the address and your note and the stamp on the back. So I use these a lot like for painting. Actually, my watercolor zine, Flora and Fauna, was all 4x6 watercolors. This is a page from that zine. So I love painting at that scale, at a small scale. But I kind of got these because I wanted to create watercolor postcards to send to my friends that maybe live in different states. So a lot of my friends still live in California, so I thought I could paint these and send them their way, and it would be like a little original right in the mail, and I don't have to like put it in an envelope or anything. So super excited about these. I'm talking really fast today. If you're like a beginner, this is a cool thing to have too. The next item I picked up was kind of something standard, but it is just an acrylic triangle. I really felt like I needed a new triangle because I have a large one. It might be somewhere in my desk drawer, but I haven't seen it in a while. And you know, rulers are great, but it's good to have the right angle because you can line it up with the corner of your page, like on the bottom. You can line it up and then you get like a perfectly straight line that is actually aligned with the paper. So I needed one of these. I got it for like $4, and I don't recommend cutting with these. I also cut my own prints, so I will be using this to draw the straight line that I will cut it with, but I would never cut against this because you know, if it was a metal ruler, you could, but with plastic or acrylic things, if you take your X-Acto against this, it'll just shave off the plastic and then you won't have a straight edge anymore. So definitely just for drawing, but I'm happy to add this to my collection. Okay, so next, something fun and unexpected was this circular canvas, which I thought was pretty exciting. I've only seen maybe like one or two artists paint on circular canvases, and you don't really see these everywhere. That's why I love Arizona Art Supply, because they have some of the cool, like, not as common stuff. Like, I don't think you're gonna find this at Michael's, you know? So my friend Suze, who's actually a fellow artist, was encouraging me to paint circular, and so I was like, okay, I'm gonna go for it. So actually, at the time of filming this video, I have my solo show on Friday, and I know it seems like last minute to be painting like in the last week, but I've made a few new paintings this week and I'm going to do something to this one for the solo show. I'm just not sure what yet. I'm thinking a moon, but I don't know if that's like too expected for a circular canvas, so maybe I'll do something else, but you know, it'll be a fun experiment, and then if I like using it, I will pick up another one. The only thing that's kind of funny is that I've told you guys before that I don't love painting on canvas. My favorite thing to paint on is wood or paper, but I did paint on two canvases for my solo show. I'm looking at them right now in my space. And I didn't really mind it. It wasn't terrible. I just don't like how canvas has the give, so when you paint on it, you kind of get that flexibility. So for example, you can see that the rim of this is really thick, so I imagine that when I'm painting anywhere in here, it's going to be nice and hard, but when I get in here, it'll be kind of annoying. But I have to say I'm getting used to it, so hopefully I will like this as well, and it won't be like a pain. I'm just like particular that way. I don't know. Okay, and I have to show you guys what I'm most excited about. The reason originally that I went to the art store was to look at this, and it was my boyfriend Jake and I's first anniversary of dating last weekend. So we went to the art store last Saturday, like almost a week ago, and he had like kind of been trying to brainstorm what to get me, and then he was like, hey, do you want an easel? And I thought it was so funny because I had actually been looking in a catalog at different easels and I really wanted one, so I was like, that's so funny that you knew I wanted that. But then we went together so that I could pick out what I wanted because he wasn't sure. And they had a bunch of like options with legs, like standing easels. And I used to have one like that, but I can't find it anywhere, which is a bummer. It's kind of okay though, because it was kind of an unstable easel. It wasn't the most like reliable thing, especially for painting. You don't want it moving around. So because I wasn't such a fan of the easel with legs, I actually ended up choosing this one, which is, oh cool, I'm glad it's in the shot. This was a tabletop easel. So how amazing is this? It's actually made out of bamboo, so it says right here, renewable resource. After I bought this, I learned that bamboo is really efficient. It grows like 3 feet a month or something, so you can feel a little bit less guilty about buying a wood product, I suppose. It goes down like this. I have a painting on it right now. This is one of my cathedral paintings for my solo show, so I'll set that aside for a second. But it has the, you know, collapsible portion here, and you can latch hook that on the top so that it doesn't like open while you're carrying it. And then it has a really nice leather handle. This thing is just like super good quality, and it's really lightweight because of the bamboo. There was another wood option that was maybe $10 cheaper, but I really wanted the bamboo one because it was so light. And I will show you guys the other features. I will say that I do not remember the brand name of this easel. I know that the model was called the Ravenna, and I will look it up and be sure to link it for you guys in the description box or on my blog when I post this video. So check it out there. The other couple features, let me unlatch this. The other couple features are that you can unscrew it here, of course, and you can extend these arms super far, and I'm pretty sure that it goes to like 34 inches. I'm not really positive, but the reason I chose this model also was, as you can see, like if I put this tabletop easel on my desk, the arm extends here and the painting extends over like into my lap, and the other options didn't do that. You only could go upward this way. So I really like this because you could put it in a sitting position, and I have a large painting right here that I will demonstrate with. I'm gonna lift this guy up a little bit here and it will show you how it works. So I kind of can have like this lip edge and work, and it overhangs over my desk a little bit, or I could lower it too. So that's really exciting. That was also another reason I picked it up. The tabletop, the only thing that's limiting with it obviously is that when you like take it out into like public, if you wanted to stand while you paint, you need to put it on a table, but like I don't really mind that at all, honestly. I want to bring this to art shows as well and be able to paint, so I would just bring like a little table, or I would set it up on the corner of my table where all of my art is being sold. So it's totally fine with me, and it's great, especially like, you know, right here in my workspace. Just barely got this, so haven't gotten a ton of use out of it yet. And then the other thing I want to show you guys about it is that it does have a storage drawer, which is awesome. So the whole thing comes out here. You can see that there's like a ton of room in it, and you can store like even really long brushes inside. So I'm just so pumped about this, and it was a really thoughtful gift. If you guys are curious about the price, I think it was $87, and after tax and everything, it was $92. So that was a really sweet gift, and I think that that's like a great price point for something like this, especially that you're going to invest in and probably have forever. So I really love it. And I'll pop this back on here, and I'll put it back up in my space. I have a couple more things to show you. I just showed you this kind of, so I will explain, but I was just showing you this larger cacti painting that I did, and I've really been wanting to work in a larger scale with my watercolors. So I bought two things that will allow me to do that. The first one is this large Strathmore sketchbook. Well, it's not really a sketchbook, it's fine paper, but it's large and it's spiral. This is the Strathmore Aquarius 2 watercolor paper, and the dimensions are 15 inches by 22 and a quarter inches. It's 80 pound cold press paper, and you get 12 sheets in here. So I picked it up, and I've been doing some large scale paintings like you see in here. And the other final thing that I bought to go along with this is a really large watercolor brush. So the largest brush that I have for watercolor is a size 10, which is a pretty standard, like, all-around size. Like, if you're gonna pick one brush, that's what I would buy. And you really only need one brush, but once you start going bigger, you're gonna want something, obviously, that you can lay on the page and get a larger stroke with. So I really wanted to pick up something bigger. I had also used a 12 in the past when I borrowed other people's brushes and, like, played around with them. But I ended up getting this one, which is the size 18 Princeton brush. It also came in this really cute bag because I guess the art store had these from Art Alternatives. And it says, make something creative, personal, useful, fun, daily, amazing, wild, new, original, imaginative, beautiful. I thought that was really cute. So I've been kind of saving this bag like for pictures and stuff. But anyway, my brush came in this bag, and like I said, it's a size 18 Princeton Neptune round brush. At the art store, this was like in the section of brushes that was just watercolor brushes. They did have another kind of like container with all the slots of different brushes that were watercolor, but they were also watercolor and acrylic, and those were actually more expensive. So I figured that I would pick up a brush that was exclusively for watercolor and it was cheaper, so it was kind of a win-win. This brush was around $20. So actually kind of funny, because my size 10 brush that I have over there, which is almost half the size of this, was also a $20 brush, but I had a coupon that time, so I got it for 10. But I think it's kind of funny that like these are the same price point, even though this is like twice the size. I don't really know what's going on with that, but all I do know is I've been using this for the past couple days, and like, holy shit, this brush is incredible. I love it so much. I even have a tiny size 4 that I use right here. This is my little watercolor box right here. But you can see that this one is like really, really tiny. I'll try and like hold it above the white there so you can see the point, but it's so much smaller, and this point on this big one is actually finer because it all comes together, and this one's kind of frayed on the end. So I've actually been using this for a lot of detail work too. It's just so comfortable in my hand. It's gorgeous, like natural coloring. It's super smooth. I could go on, but I will stop. It's just really good. So if you're looking for a larger brush, that's what I'm using, and I would recommend it. So we covered everything, I think, from paper to triangles, canvases, brushes, and that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed seeing all of my supplies. If you would like to see what I do with these supplies, I would encourage you to follow me on Periscope. I don't know if I've talked about Periscope here in a while, but I'm super active on it, and I do a lot of live painting. I also give advice for having a creative business, and I've been using a lot of these supplies on there. So it's always fun for you guys to be able to tune in and see them like in action being used, especially if you're considering buying them for yourself. And other than that, I would encourage you guys to subscribe. I have like so many things to tell you. There's also a link in this description box where you can download a free art print to hang in your space and get inspired if you would like to. And finally, I will probably talk about this in a future video, but our podcast, which Asia and I have talked about a few videos ago, is live. We have 3 episodes up as of today. It is called spacetoface.com. And if you are a creative business owner or are planning to become one or have any interest in it, we would encourage you to check it out because our podcast talks all about bridging the gap between like the online aspects of your business as well as in-person aspects and kind of blending both of them together. So, also, if you just happen to want to know more about me, maybe there are 2 bonus episodes up, which are us interviewing each other. So I talk a lot more about like my art career and like how I got started and my path with all of that and like my inspiration and everything. So that is the first bonus episode. I'm gonna stop rambling now. I just feel like I need to catch you guys up. I talk about all these things on my social media, especially Instagram, Snapchat, and Periscope is where I'm the most active. So I'm always updating you guys there. But I wanted to say it here too, just in case you don't follow me in those places. But now you know, so now you should. Okay, guys, I want to thank you so much for watching. It means so much to me. I'm always appreciative, so grateful for you guys. So thank you, as always, and sending all of the positive and creative vibes your way. And I don't know why I'm doing so many finger guns today, but I will see you in my next video. Bye!